Hey everybody, it's me! I don't even know who I am anymore, and welcome back to more Let's Play Lisa the Painful. The last video was recorded back in November, and here it is at the very end of January. As you can tell, I've been busy. Although, to be fair, I don't even know my upload schedule anymore, man. I tried to do every other day, and then life happens fast, and I have a cat. So, moving on. Last video, we defeated the super boss of the game. Satan. Or, rather, just a guy named Mike. Let's just be real here. And for defeating him, we got ourselves Mike's belt buckle, the best accessory in the game. Anyways, since last time, I've actually messed around a little bit with Crisp. I've never used him, and I leveled him up a little bit there, just to kind of mess around. And this episode is going to be horrible life decisions. But to be fair, it's Lisa the Painful, so what else do you expect? Because I did say I really want to use Harvey, Fly, and Ajit. I want to keep things fresh, so I'm going to be replacing Harvey, Fly, and Ajit for this video, at the very least, by having a 20-sided die. I've counted how many party members I have outside of these four, and I have exactly 20. So I'm going to take the d20 here, I'm going to roll it, and that's who we're going to be using to replace Harvey, Fly, and Ajit with. So here we go. I dropped the die. Dang it. Let's try that again. There we are. First one, number 9. All right. Second one is 11. And the third one is 5. All right. So we got 5, 9, 11. Time to change out Harvey with number 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's Tiger Man. Fly was number 9. So it's number 6, 7, 8, 9. Rooster. And Ajit was 11. Which is 10, 11, Beastborn. So we got Brad, Rooster, and Beastborn. Oh, fantastic. This'll be great, I'm sure. Let's just optimize their equipment here, shall we? Oh, Beastborn, you really shouldn't wear the American flag. That's disrespectful to the country. But again, like I mentioned in a previous video, it kind of gives you plot armor. You cannot legally destroy it. Not as far as I'm aware, anyways. So, with that being said, let's get this show on the road. And it's time to begin the final place with some poppin' music. Oh, there are a couple of things in here, and I intend to get them both. The first thing that is in here, I believe, is down here to the right. Yep, there we go. Dojo. The final dojo of the game. And it is actually the most challenging. Wheezy Silver's Kung Fu Gauntlet. Can you even handle my Doomsday technique? It will ruin you, destroy you, totally fuck you up. You know, I'm ready. Yeah. I think I'm man enough. We've got a gauntlet to go through. And away we go. This is the gauntlet. And that one gave me joy addiction. Fantastic. I'm suffering through this, as are you. And I'm going to make a terrible life decision here. I'm actually going to have a swig of alcohol, because why not? I think that I have earned it after that gauntlet. The very painful gauntlet. And I got a karate scroll. Oh, I will. The karate scroll that we just got, it is written in Oriental language, and it must be authentic in comparison to the others. And we are going to be using this on Brad. There we are. Ow. I forgot about that on the way back. But it's fine. And there we go. So, that is the last scroll of the game. And we also have down here to the right. I swear, it's somewhere here on the right, like this, right now. We got two items. We got Grandma's shawl and Grandpa's shirt. Let's read them, shall we? Grandma's shawl, a shawl of legend. And Grandpa's shirt, the legendary blouse of a retiree. This shirt has seen many games of golf. Because of course it has. None of you can equip those? Seriously? Like, none of you can equip. Well, I was hoping to actually use them, but oh, I know I can. You can actually equip Grandpa's shirt, but it's not as good as the flag of the US of A. Oh well. We got ourselves a tree to carve. Again, with poppin' music. Oh snap! Blood Coyote. Oh, this is just great. We're both under a joy addiction. And I'm trying to remember Tiger Man's attacks here. Let me see her skills. Okay, we got... Huh. Alright. All of these are... That one's just sad. A half-hearted spear move. All right, sure, why not? Hmm. I'm gonna try and knock you over. Or stunning you, rather. Ow. Ooh, he's bleeding at least. Got that going for us. Excuse me. Slap him! Uh-oh, he's angry. Ah, you missed, Rooster. This fight is taking unnecessarily long, just because of the addiction. Oh, I finally stunned him. What a surprise. And he's no longer stunned, because of course he's not. Let's actually have a critter. I'm gonna throw a deer at him. It's only appropriate. Yep, there goes Tiger Man. That's unfortunate. And I KO'd him by throwing a deer in his face. Proud of you, Beastborn. Oh, he gave me domestic jerky and some cola. Do I have anything that can revive you? Yes, I do. Domestic jerky restores 1,000. That restores all. I forgot I also had 4 bottles of soup. Yeah, we'll do that. Why not? Should be good now. What is... Nope, nothing down there. Blood Mountain. Why does that sound like Splash Mountain, but more metal? We'll try and paralyze you. Why not? We'll give it a whirl. Ouch. Hey, I'm no longer under withdrawal. So we got that going for us at least. I thought I was Tiger Man there. Oh well, either way, he's down. Famous last words? Something like that? Let's see. Cool. Yeah, that should be fine. Hopefully. Bloodhawk. Why am I seeing a recurring theme involving blood? I'm kind of scared here. I'm gonna throw roosters at you. I can't throw a deer, but I can whip you. Stun him! Yay! And he's no longer stunned. Dag nabbit. Ouch. His song will make us all dance. Well, considering that we got awesome music going on in the background here, yeah, I'm dancing. Are you dancing? If you're not, you're doing it wrong. Is there another hidden person I can fight for some experience points? Blood Bull. Blood Bullshit. Never mind. This is a children's television program, and I am not allowed to say the word shit. What have I done? Actually, if this were a children's television program, I would be awful at it. So for those of you viewing at home, do not repeat after me, please. Not what I intended, but I'll take it. I took that too. You've met him. The song that makes us all dance, he had her, or he birthed her, so he shall have her, and we've met him. I don't recall what the first thing was, which is just me being a doofus, completely overlooking it, fully admittingly. Yeah, that should be good. We'll restore some HP to you. Okay, we're good. Whee! Up here. Ooh, a save crow. I bet you there's someone hiding right there. Nope, there's not. Awesome. Alright, well, here we are. The very top of the mountain. Probably with... Blood. The painted sky should tell you everything. Yes, it's painted red, like blood. Can we talk about this, sir? Bloodiest wolf. God dang it. Okay, listen. Whenever I was saying blood, I was joking. And I guess I'm not joking anymore then. Fair enough. I'm gonna throw roosters at you and I'm gonna whip you. Ooh! Wait, Beastborn, you're weak to that? Oh, crud. Oh, that's unfortunate. Throw more roosters at him! And pile drive a deer into him! I'm throwing deer and chickens. Why is that not doing any damage? You're not even under withdrawal, Tiger Man. What's going on? Dude, get your act together, please. I'm just gonna keep throwing chickens at him. And trying to headbutt him into submission. Oh, hey, there we go. He was submitted. Ha ha! Take that, nerd. And I made him bleed. Yay. Progress has been made upon this day. Nah, just keep throwing chickens at him. It's funny. I'm also gonna try Whip Flurry. See if that do anything good. Oh! Oh my goodness! I did not like that. Oh, that hurt. You attack, you heal yourself immediately. Actually, no, I'm gonna make you use horse jerky. You heal yourself, and you just whip him. Hopefully I can stun him. Dag nabbit. Oh, great. And you're on fire, Beastborn. Okay. Hustle drop kick, why not? And deer driver. Stun lock the man like you can in fighting games. There we go, that's what I wanted. Can remember the attack order. Well, Beastborn, I'm so sorry, man, but you are paralyzed. And you're still on fire. I forgot about that. Okay. No, I'm not going to waste a rando ration on you. I will drop a horse jerky on you, though. Oh, hey, look at that. I win! After punching him. A lot. And stabbing him. A lot. And throwing chickens at him. A lot. I'm happy that we won. Ooh, I learned fly swatter. Why do I get the feeling you're not going to hit flies with that? Chop down the tree? Nah, I gotta respect his wishes, man. I can't do that. You know, it's the last blood tree after all. But, to be fair, he did nearly kill us. Yeah, let's chop it down. I got some fine wood. You know, out of curiosity, I really have to wonder. Why couldn't we have just taken what remained of the previous blood trees and tried to craft something out of that? Whatever. Either way, it doesn't matter. Bloodwood. A slimy green wood with bright red sap. Mint cloth. It's hard to find cloth this nice nowadays. And lastly, a large fan, which could possibly have been a family heirloom once upon a time. But there we go. We officially have all of the things that we require in order to progress with the plot. That was a fun hootin' time. And I'm afraid that I'm out of time, speaking of that. So, in the next video, I will have joy addiction. But ultimately, in the next episode, we are actually going to be able to progress onward to a new place. Because there he is. There's Tardy. I remembered your name, because it was funny sounding. Anyways, thank you all for watching my terrible, awful series, and I will see you in the next video. Have a good day. Bye-bye. Geronimo! I can't swim. Not with one arm. Darn it.